Hey guys, welcome back. Sorry, I'm super excited today. We're talking about Spider-Man No Way Home, finally. This is the best, I think one of the best Marvel movies I've ever seen, ever, ever. Let's talk about how everyone's being mean to Jake Gyllenhaal again because Taylor released All Too Well and now people are talking about how he created all the problems and he's the reason everyone knows who Peter Parker is, right? You know, he's the reason everyone knows who Peter Parker is. I absolutely love Zendaya as MJ. I think she's super awkward, but also like super cute. I don't know. There's so much of this movie in my brain. I'm not going to be able to like talk about it in the right way. Start talking about stuff in the chat, guys, because I'm going to be all over the place. Doctor Strange, I feel like, was weird and was not actually Doctor Strange. I don't know about you guys, but I feel like he would have never, like, done a spell for Peter to make people forget him. Like, I don't know. I feel like that was not Doctor Strange. People were talking about it being a variant since Loki did all the timeline stuff. Everyone kind of had an idea that, like, Andrew Garfield and Tobey Maguire were going to be in it, but we didn't actually know. Literally in my theater, everyone freaked out when Andrew Garfield came. And then when Tobey Maguire came in, the whole theater was screaming. Everybody was screaming. I like Andrew Garfield. I grew up with Tobey Maguire, so I like love seeing him like as Spider-Man. So like everybody was just freaking out. I went with my friend who doesn't really watch Marvel movies like that, but he's seen Spider-Man. And he literally was like, what the fuck? Like, I'm right next to him and I'm like, oh my god, oh my god. I'm like, it's Andrew Garfield and Tobey Maguire. Like, and he's like, I know that they're the other Spider-Man, but he was like, I feel like a loser because everyone's freaking out and I feel like I'm like need to go watch all these movies. Like, I feel like I'm missing out on something. And I was like, yeah, I said, you gotta go watch them now. He's gonna go watch all the Marvel movies, but I didn't know who Daredevil was and I felt like a loser when he came in. But I've heard, now I'm gonna start watching that. I'm gonna watch Daredevil because everyone says it's really good. That was one of the best scenes, Tao. All three Spider-Man swinging in together. They did the meme. They did the fucking Spider-Man meme where they're all pointing at each other, okay? Yes, they did that meme. They had, oh my god, when all the Spider-Man were talking and they were like talking about how Tobey Maguire has his webs and how he makes it because it just comes out of his hand. I was cracking up. Andrew Garfield saved MJ in this universe. And he started crying after. And that's how, like, I don't know if you've ever seen The Amazing Spider-Man. It's like Andrew Garfield and Gwen, the girl who plays Gwen Stacy is Emma Stone, and she dies in like the second movie, and he uses his webs to try and like help her after she's fallen off like a clock tower and she dies. So there's one point in this movie where this MJ, Zendaya, falls off the tower or whatever, and Tom Holland goes to like catch her, and then the goblin comes in and gets him out of the way, so she's still falling, and then you see Andrew Garfield Spider-Man jumping down and saves her, and then he starts crying and she's like, are you okay? And he's like, yeah, but like it's so sad. I feel like I need to go watch all the Spider-Man movies now, like every single one of them. William Dafoe, is that how you say his name? Legit scares me. He's like, I used to be so scared of him as the Green Goblin in like the first Spider-Man's with Tobey Maguire. He still scares me. He just is such a good actor and it just freaks me out. Like, it really does. I warned my friend before the movie. Before the movie, I said, you might see me cry. I don't know if you've ever seen me cry. Maybe when I've been drunk and cried. I was like, but I don't think you've actually ever seen me cry. I was like, I don't know what's gonna happen in this movie, but I'm expecting that I'm going to cry. The second Aunt May died. Bro, Tom Holland is such a good actor. He was literally bawling his eyes out in the pouring rain. And Aunt May's done. He has no family. Like, there's no Iron Man anymore. So there's no Tony Stark. And there's no Aunt May. He has literally nobody except for Ned and MJ. That's like all who he has left, okay? Then, at the end, when he made everyone forget him, He literally is completely alone. MJ doesn't know who he is. Ned doesn't know who he is. He's literally by himself. Nobody knows who he is. Nobody remembers him. I literally cried so hard. I love Tobey Maguire, though. Like, he was like, you're amazing. You're amazing. You need to feel that you're amazing, you know? The dialogue between all of them was just so good. The scenes with them was just so good. Yeah, everybody was screaming. Oh, I loved it. I loved the atmosphere, though, because, like, I went, like, a couple of days later, and I took my sister, and nobody, like, people kind of screamed when, like, Tobey Maguire showed up, but, like, people screamed in, like, opening night when they saw Daredevil, when, like, anything, like, little happened that you realize, like, when all the true fans are there that go to see it opening night, you know? And it's just something else. It's so fun to be a part of, you know? There's a point where Tom Holland's fighting Green Goblin, and Green Goblin is who killed Aunt May, so, you know, he wants to get his revenge and everything, and Tobey Maguire steps in front of him and, like, is, like, telling him, like, not to do it. But, like, Green Goblin's, like, on the ground behind him. I knew he was gonna get stabbed or something. I knew it. As soon as Tobey Maguire stepped in front of the Green Goblin, I knew he was gonna get hurt or something. So then Green Goblin stabbed him. But I'm glad that he didn't die from that, because I thought he was gonna die from that. But I liked how they cured everybody, cured all the villains instead of killing them. Like, I don't know. I feel like that's just, like, brings in so many possibilities. Yeah, it's literally Arrow. It literally kills me that he's all by himself. And when he walked in and it was MJ and Ned talking at the table, like, he realized that his friends are better off without him, so he didn't say anything, and it's like, rip my heart out, why don't you? I like how they did it, though, because I think they had all of the Spider-Mans in the movie for the right amount of time. Like, it wasn't, like, they didn't take away from Tom Holland at all. They had them, they came in pretty late in the movie, helped them defeat everyone else, and then went back to their universes, and still we had some scenes afterwards. So I thought it was perfect how it was still Tom Holland's movie, but they did it in such a good way. Did everyone stay for the end credit scenes? Because you have to stay for the end credit scenes. I've only seen the shows on Disney Plus. I've never seen, like, the MCU, like, the Marvel shows on Netflix, so that means I need to watch them. Yeah, I stayed for the end credit scenes, but I was so hyped when I saw Wanda in the trailer for Doctor Strange in the Multiverse, and it's so crazy because these shows that they have for these characters, Wanda, Vision, Bucky, Sam, even Hawkeye, I have such a different appreciation for them, seeing them, like, in a different light, because they don't have, like, they have big parts in the movies, but, like, you know, it's not Captain America, it's not Iron Man, so by them having their own shows, it made me appreciate their characters so much more. So, like, I love Wanda now. She's, like, one of my favorites. Loki, I always liked Loki, but, you know, getting to see more of, like, his life and his story and everything, like, it's just so much better, and it gives you so much more of an appreciation for the characters that they are. Even Hawkeye. I did not care for Hawkeye, and then I watched Hawkeye, and I was like, okay. He's just a dad. He wants to be with his family, you know. There's a rumor of Spider-Gwen coming into Sony Universe with Emma Stone. Yeah, see. I also heard that, so since Tom Holland signed on for, like, another trilogy for him during college, people think that Ned and MJ are going to end up dating, and then he's gonna find his Gwen Stacy, and Ned's gonna try to kill him because they don't know who he is. Oh, it's so stressful. I just feel so bad. Like, it literally, like, that movie tore me apart when he lost Aunt May, and then he only had MJ and Ned, and then now he has no one. He has nobody now. But now people think that Doctor Strange in the Multiverse is going to set it up for Wanda. And then, like, people are saying Wanda's dad is, what's his name from X-Men? I don't know. I can't keep up with all the theories and shit, but not Wolverine. But it's someone else. It's the guy who controls things with his mind. Magneto. Yes, Magneto. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like this was, like, really making him into Spider-Man now, because like before he had Tony Stark's technology and everything, now he doesn't. And Happy at the end, when Happy was like at the grave and they were visiting Aunt May, and he was like, how'd you know her? And he's like, through Spider-Man. I was like, oh my god. Now there also is a theory that people that aren't on Earth will remember who he is. So like Thor and Captain Marvel and them, and like Nick Fury, because Nick Fury's not on Earth. There's a theory that they'll know who Peter Parker is, that Peter Parker is Spider-Man. So I don't know about that, but I honestly think my favorite part was when they started to come through the portals, and then when they were all talking all together. But even the fight scenes were really great in the show, and they had all three Spider-Man swing in, and they had the famous line, "With great power comes great responsibility," and then Aunt May died. That's how you know. That's how you know she's done for. That was the moment I knew. So. But yeah, let me know what your favorite parts of No Way Home were.
To see content like this live, make sure to follow me on Twitch. If you guys enjoyed that video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.